Senator Markey for your continued leadership on this issue and on many issues, but especially on passenger rail, which we consider enormously important. Thank you to Mayor Springfield for welcoming us to this beautiful place. I was here with Congressman Neal filming last September, and then I had the chance to join Senator Markey and Senator McGovern at the Congressman at the Worcester station when he announced the brain train. I'm going to talk about that, but let me just explain. I'm Karen Christensen. I'm from Great Barrington. I'm a Berkshire's. I run the train campaign, which is one of the members of the Western Mass Rail Coalition. There are other members of that coalition here. There are representatives from the Chester Railway Station, from Trains in the Valley, which is the Pioneer Valley, that is, and then from Citizens for a Palmer Rail Stop. A couple of years ago, we began working together because we feel that there are some special considerations for Western Massachusetts, and that advocacy needs to be, especially in a rural and unconnected region like ours, needs to be coordinated. And we have worked together on a variety of issues. I was inspired, in fact, to get involved in this after taking trains in Europe, and especially in China, seeing how transformative they can be. It is an absolute joy to have seen the bipartisan infrastructure bill passed in the Senate. And we are strongly urge our Democratic leadership in that House of Representatives to pass this bill as quickly as possible. I know that there are more investments coming to restore the prosperity of the United States, but and some of those will deal with climate change, but I want to emphasize today how much this infrastructure bill, and particularly the passenger rail provisions in it, will contribute to a climate-resilient future for this country, as well as to economic prosperity for regions, for cities, and for rural regions like ours. And I am going to say something for Western Massachusetts in particular. I think that this part of the world has been innovative in many ways. I think we're going to be innovative in rail. We're going to establish models that can be used elsewhere in this country, because we're dealing with many of the same challenges of rural regions, people who've been cut off, who've been left behind. That's true of many communities in Western Massachusetts. And rail projects like East-West Rail, the Berkshire-Housatonic Line, and other initiatives, the Inland Route, these all are part of a system. Trains don't go A to B, B to A. They are a system, and we can create a transformative system in this part of the world, which will be a model as we've been a model in many other ways.